There's a diet that's been proposed, and for good reason, to completely eradicate heart disease. As in, it's claimed that if you eat this diet, it eliminates heart disease even if you have heart disease, giving you 100% protection from any cardiovascular event like a heart attack, stroke, or anything related. That idea has been popularized by a physician and scientist, Dr. Caldwell Esselstyn, who has published several studies on the matter. So I'd like to open up some of these studies, get to the bottom of the topic, and then introduce you to some nuances that I think are often ill-described. The study that's most popular is this one, and by the title, you can see why. In this study, researchers, including Dr. Esselstyn, who we'll hear from later, had 198 highly motivated people that started on an extreme diet. The diet was simply characterized as a whole food, plant-based, and importantly, oil-free diet. All oils are prohibited, in addition to any animal products, as well as nuts, avocados, excess salt, caffeine, kill me now, and if you're wondering what these people were allowed to eat, whole grains, legumes, lentils, vegetables, and fruits. Since these participants were highly motivated considering that they had coronary artery disease, they were on this diet for an average of 3.7 years. And then the researchers measured the plaque in the arteries before and after the diet for some of the participants, as well as tracked if the disease presented itself in all participants, as in, did some experience cardiovascular issues during that time. In fact, the most impressive results are shown here. On the left is the left anterior descending artery, which is the artery of the heart that's often called the widowmaker, because it's so deadly if it's blocked. You can see on the left image, the vessel is much thinner than in the post image on the right side, which shows a thickening of the white space. So that's called the lumen of the artery. That means that the body was able to remove the plaque and reopen the artery, which is an incredible image. I mean, truly. This is further confirmed by this image. The coloration there indicates the amount of blood flow to the heart, specifically the myocardium, a section of the heart. The top is before the diet, and the bottom is after the diet. Again, a massive difference. Now, I call this the most impressive results, and they are, but they are also disappointing in some key ways. Well, for one, these are representative images, but as far as I could tell, no averages, so across all the participants, were reported in this study. This is important because someone could just show images of an outlier, a person who did better than everyone else in this instance, and bamboozle us all. I don't think that actually happened here for reasons that we're about to get into, but it's still a weakness of the study. A second weakness is the fact that this wasn't a controlled study, as in there was no control group. So to see if there were results that might also be experienced in the control group, taking some power away from the idea that this specific diet causes these benefits. Practically, this probably doesn't matter much, but scientifically, it matters. On the other hand, the researchers reported the number of people who experienced actual cardiac events, like heart attacks and strokes, and those results are also remarkable and displayed here. On the left are the adherent participants, so people who stuck to this restrictive diet that we discussed earlier, and the right side is 21 individuals who were banished from this land for rebelling against the king. Or they were just people who didn't stick to the diet as well as they should have, just couldn't resist having coffee. I empathize. We also see outcomes, which is the cardiovascular outcomes like angina or chest pain due to likely a lack of blood flow to the heart. As we can see, 105 of 177 individuals experienced improvements in symptoms, 39 experienced actual reversal, and 15 remained stable, leaving 18 individuals as getting worse. Now, at the beginning of this video, we discussed 100% protection from cardiovascular events. So how could people be getting worse if they were adhering to this diet? Well, I'll let Dr. Esselstyn answer that.
In our 2014 paper, yes, there was one patient who had gone on vacation to China, absolutely began eating off the economy. He had a tendency to have hypertension and, of course, all the salt, and he had a small cerebellar stroke. He did not follow the program. He is the one patient in he was somehow made it into the compliant group. That not compliance, going off on the economy. And so really, therefore, in that group, nobody had an event over close to 4 years, 177 patients.
So, Dr. Esselstyn's point is that one person was mischaracterized as compliant or adherent, when in reality they were not, which is why they experienced a stroke. I assume that's this one here. And then several more participants had cardiovascular issues due to, according to the researchers, unrelated reasons. For example, undergoing a heart surgery on the advice of their physician. So, in the best case scenario, the diet did not result in any cardiovascular events. And the worst case scenario, 10% of people still experienced an event, related or unrelated. The nice thing about reporting the non-adherent individuals is that they can make a comparison between the diet and not following the diet. It's not a true control group, but it offers a comparison in that people who did not follow the diet, so 62%, got worse and none got better. That's a stark difference compared to the people who were adherent. Now, there's a few things to say about this all. Before that, there are multiple studies using varying diets to show arterial plaque reversal. So, what I did was compile all these studies and identify the trends across all these diets and identify what are the likely greatest factors. I put them together into a guide that I wrote out for the Physionic Insiders. If you're interested, the link to join is in the description. I promise it's far less restrictive than the no-oil diet specifics that we're about to go over. Check it out. Okay, so depending on how we look at things, this no-oil diet seems to significantly improve the odds of not experiencing cardiovascular issues. I think some of my hesitation related to this diet is that the studies that have been done on it, because there's actually another one that's been done like 12 years with a much smaller group, but showed similar amazing results, both of them have absolutely horrid study design. I realize I'm going to get some flack from the plant-based community here, but there's a lot to say here. And I really think that I'm being fair, including my final point that I'm going to make. Okay, first, as I alluded, none of these studies are controlled studies. So no randomization, no researcher blinding, no power calculations, no controls, and so on. Second, many of these studies rely on categorical data and don't report much on average data, including standard errors and the like. We have to trust that the researcher's assessment of what is significant and what is not significant, while average data leaves it up to the reader, the analyzer. Third, actually, let me turn to Dr. Carvalho's question in his interview with Dr. Esselstyn. The video to this will also be linked underneath for you too.
So that was one of the questions I had, and I've had people ask me that. Why hasn't there been, after all this time, as you said, Dr. Ornish and your work has been around for 30 plus years, very interesting, encouraging findings. Why hasn't someone taken that and run a randomized trial just with your diet, very low fat, plant exclusive or plant overwhelmingly plant, and seen if it reverses heart disease? It's surprising to me that that hasn't been done.
This is such a good question because it's been something like 30 years of us getting these methodologically weak studies to indicate that this diet works, especially when we have many, many studies that look at other nutrition styles and their cardiovascular effects, including some in plaque reversal. Let's hear Dr. Esselstyn's perspective on why a randomized controlled trial has not been done.
Well, in a sense, there's never any nutrition in medical school that is worth its weight. I mean, maybe in your freshman or sophomore year, you get a lecture on cholesterol, but not on the fact that it can actually eliminate men, that we're the leading killer of women and men in Western civilization. Now, there are other things that I've always resisted, as a reason why people haven't jumped on it. They, cardiology never gets any training in nutrition, even in their cardiology years. When we did it out of the American College of Cardiology, we did that survey, and in the cardiologists themselves conceded they get very little. It's negligible the amount of nutrition training they get. So when they are never trained in the cure of the disease, or for that matter, they're never trained in the causation mm-hmm. of the disease, then it's no great surprise. And also, when you are doing, not everybody has sparks flying out of their eyes when they are asked to spend a half an hour talking with a patient day after day after day after day with nutrition and how to do it. Now, there's some of us who have that quirk about us that seem to enjoy that. Mm-hmm. Now, the other one I have avoided for the longest time, but I'm going to say it today. How much do you suppose you get paid for bypass surgery? How much do you suppose you get paid for stents or for heaping drugs onto people compared to talking to somebody about Brussels sprouts and broccoli?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there's a huge financial situation here and almost every hospital worth its salt, the biggest bottom line figure on that hospital comes from their treatment of cardiovascular disease. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure it's a factor. I would love to see, in addition to all the trials that people are carrying out with Mediterranean diets and with DASH diets, it would be really interesting to see a trial where these different dietary approaches are compared side by side so we can have some more conclusive answers.
I don't see how you can ask a patient to eat one of those diets when it's never been shown to arrest and reverse disease. I don't know how an IRB would ever close it when we've got data that shows it doesn't have to happen.
Okay, there's a lot there. I don't doubt that financial interests are a motivating, or in this case, a demotivating factor. I also don't doubt that a lack of education in the medical field on nutrition is a player. However, that doesn't explain why we have so many trials on so many other diets doing exactly what we're asking of this diet. So scientists and clinicians are uneducated on nutrition when it comes to an oil-free plant-based nutrition, but they suddenly spring into action if it's a DASH diet or the Mediterranean diet and so on. That reasoning doesn't exactly square. In addition, saying that it's unethical to put people on these diets seems a little extreme to me, especially when we have better evidence, more solid evidence for the aforementioned reason, indicating that their profound positive cardiovascular impact. Finally, allow me to mention that I realize I'm being a bit harsh here. There are multiple reasons for that I'm disappointed that this kind of controlled study hasn't been done in decades. I'm also annoyed because the strong rhetoric that gets enunciated, yet the evidence, while impressive, is, if we're being unbiased, very weak, methodologically speaking. Finally, I actually believe Dr. Esselstyn's results and these studies, but they aren't being contextualized correctly. And I can't in good faith argue this no-oil diet is actually better without any true comparative studies. So the takeaway here is that there is some extremely impressive but methodologically flawed evidence that indicates a no-oil plant-based diet severely cuts down and possibly eliminates future atherosclerosis-related cardiovascular disease risk in people with already known cardiovascular disease. Actually, Dr. Esselstyn even argues that olive oil causes heart disease, which I cover in this next video, including randomized studies on other diets that significantly improve heart disease. I'll see you over there.